this over here on the left. Phone rang a little bit ago, probably Paul. So I could see what was going on down the river here. It's a lot better if you travel frequently so you get a good barometer of what's here, what might be here, what's going away, what's coming up. Anyway, I'm going to wash up, check my phone, have a sandwich. I'll be back. Well, it was Paul on the phone. We're gonna get into our wet ones here, clean up a bit. I don't know what time it is, but we're riding our trikes at 7 tonight. And I told Paul it would be a perfect timing. Give me a chance to get home, get a shower. Take the bike to Pigeon Forge, go back to the truck, take the truck home, load the trike, take the trike to Pigeon Forge. One more bridge to pass under, and I already know we're going to go to the right, because I saw it this morning, and it's pretty full of trees on the left. That's back under the parkway. Right near the apple barn. The right side is generally clear, and it was nothing more in a kayaker's favor for safety than river familiarity. It's like knowing your roads, knowing your intersection on the right. I generally don't kayak by myself. I like the buddy system. I've got you with me. And we filed a good float plan, so everybody knows where we are. Got our safety gear. A tricky little section coming up here. I'm going to stay to the extreme left. You see where that orange vest or whatever it is? There are some huge boulders out here in the middle. I ran a canoe up on one time and thought I'd not get it off. So I'm gonna tie this up front here. There's a heron that has been in front of me almost from the time we left the put-in area. And he flies around a bend, and when I approach, he flies further downstream. You'll probably hear him first before you see him. There he is, way down there. He's way down there. he just rounded that curve as far down as you can see. So pretty flat through here. I'll turn the camera off. This is a pretty nice job of architecture up here. Be able to tell about where you are if you look right over there. I'm guessing right in this area here. That's the Titanic attraction. So if you were to go by the apple barn and take the first road to the left, that's where we are, right along in here. It's a dead end road. Come to these condos. Look pretty over here. Take you down another set of rapids here. Normally I'd go under that tree there, but I think I'm going to try to stay a little bit to the left of it. That's your heron show for the day, I think. There were two of them out here. I said one rounded the bend, and as soon as I said it was pretty far off, there was another one not too far ahead of me at that point. Sometimes I'll see hawks out here. I haven't seen any eagle up here. I have seen them behind my house, a pair of them. Ducks, actually geese, so far up there they look like ducks. Can you hear the Titanic music? there's my ride. And we got the kayak all hosed down, all the gears washed off. We've got life jacket, tote bags rinsed off and hanging. Oh, isn't that pretty? Well, this is where we started from. Right over next to that picnic table. There we go. Go home. Yesterday at this time I was on the river. Today it's not going to happen. Came up last night probably another foot and a half, maybe even two above where it is now. You can see where the debris line is, water line. And it will come up again probably later on this afternoon. We've got rain moving in the area in about 2 hours. So this is water that was up in the mountains last night. If we didn't get a whole lot of rain here, it was up in the mountains. So when you've got time on your hands to enjoy cooling down, because it's hot yet today and the clouds are coming up pretty quick, you just ride when you can, whatever you can, whether it be a tricycle, bicycle, canoe, kayak.